Hello! So this is the first video in a series of three where I will be compiling a sort of starting out kit when it comes to makeup. The first thing is something on your face, like foundation or a tinted moisturizer. If I were to go out and get something for my face, I would probably opt for a foundation. It doesn't have to be this one, of course. This is just an example. But you should have a moisturizer already for your face. And then, if you then get a foundation, you can make a tinted moisturizer. So, if I were to choose between the two, I would get a foundation because you get kind of two in one with a foundation. I won't get into the whole match your color type thing because either I suggest having someone to help you, or even go to say a MAC store or MAC counter or department store, any place that would sell foundations and you could get help with color matching. Because I know my shade in this particular foundation from MAC, and I will link this below, but it's a great little matrix of foundation shades. And if you go to a MAC store and have some help picking out your shade, you can go to this matrix and you can see what that shade would be in all other foundations, both drugstore and high-end and everything. Number two on my list is a concealer. Now, this is a Laura Mercier one, so I don't have a cheaper option for this, unfortunately, but this is just an example as well. And I bought this because it has... I used this today, so it doesn't look as pristine as when I got it the first time. But this has two compartments, sort of. This peachy pinkish shade is meant for under your eyes, and this other shade is meant for general, like, blemishes and stuff on your face. So my suggestion is to find one that will work for both. And then I have setting powder. If you want to have a loose powder, I suggest going for something like this, because this was somewhere between $3 and $5, I believe. And it's just a basic loose powder that sort of disappears on the skin. But the other option for a powder is getting something like this, which is MAC Mineralized Skin Finish Natural. And if you're curious, my shade is Medium Plus. I don't know why, but apparently it is. And the good thing about this particular product, again, used this today, so it's a little dusty. Looks like this. This is something that you could just pop on over, say, your moisturizer, and you don't really have to wear foundation underneath this. But you could also set your foundation, your liquid foundation, or your homemade tinted moisturizer with this. So again, it's a kind of like a two-in-one. And then, blush. Find something that works for you and your budget. That's pretty much it. I'd only show examples anyway. So these two, this is NARS Deep Throat, which is, I would say it's a kind of pale pink, and it has some slight shimmers to it. Very slight, it doesn't really show up on my skin. And this is a MAC powder blush in Melba, which is, it has a hint of peach to it, but it's very, very nude, at least on my skin. It's very nude looking, like natural nude looking. So when it comes to blush, and also if you want to save some money, I recommend going for something that you could wear all the time. Like, no matter what you choose to wear on your eyes or your lips, no matter the season, like summer or winter, a blush that would work on your skin tone all year round and with any makeup look you choose to do is preferred, because then you just need one, really. Then, let's see, we go into the eye makeup, sort of. And the first thing, and this, depending on how they look and how you like them, this may be optional, but the thing is, I recommend getting something for your eyebrows to fill them in a little, because you can get away with doing a whole lot less makeup on an everyday basis if you just fill in your eyebrows slightly and you just kind of frame your face and you look very polished and put together just by doing that. It's MAC lingering, and you just kind of twist it like this and it comes up through the top here. So I use this every single day. And then mascara. I only picked up one, and this is a drugstore one. It is Maybelline The Colossal Volume Express Mascara, and this type is called Cat Eyes. It's in a yellow tube with a cheetah print on it. And basically, just find a mascara and a formula and a brush that works for you. This is a spoon brush, which is okay. It's not, I mean, I don't have a particular preference really when it comes to mascara wands and such, but just find a mascara that works for you and one you will like. And this is something you don't really need to spend a lot of money on, I think, because you're supposed to throw out your mascara every 3 months anyway, so spending, well, in the US, $25 some on a high-end mascara isn't really that good an idea. But something like this in the US would cost between $5 and $8, I think. So yeah, something that works but isn't too expensive, because you will be switching it out, hopefully, on a regular basis. And then when it comes to eyeliners, I have 3 variations. The Urban Decay 24/7 Glide-On Pencil, Eye Pencil in 0, which is a pencil. But this is very, very soft. So, if you were to pick just one type of eyeliner, I would actually prefer this. We have eyeshadows, and I have quite a few options for this. I have 2 palettes, and I have 2 quads. I didn't bring any quints with me, but you get the idea. So, if you were to buy only one eyeshadow palette or quad, I would pick something that you would wear every single day if you intend to wear makeup every single day. Now, for me in particular, that means neutrals and nudes. So in my everyday kit, I have the Naked palette by Urban Decay, because it has all of these pretty colors. Now, this does cost a little, so maybe Christmas present, something like that, birthday gift. And if you do want to splurge on something, I have to say I do recommend this. Because the quality is amazing, and you will have this for a long, long time, even though you wear it every single day. So you get a nice variety of colors. Granted, they are mostly neutrals and nudes. So if you prefer a whole lot of color, and you prefer like colorful looks and such, I know I don't have them, but I know like BH Cosmetics, I think, and a few other brands, they carry the 88 palette with a whole lot of colors. But I have an example of mine, which is by H&M Cosmetics. It has a whole bunch of colors, and it works fine. The quality of these eyeshadows It's not the same as this, but then again, this cost me around about $12, and this is like, I don't know, 40-something dollars. So, yeah. But if you do want lighter color, this is a good way to go. Like any palette that you would get lighter color in. This also has a lot of neutrals on this side, so this works fine for me as well. We move on to lip products. And here as well, I have a few ideas. So my basic idea is to have as few things as possible, but you can do a lot with them. And as with blush, I do suggest going for something that's like a universal color that you can wear both summer and winter, and with any makeup look you do, like on your eyes. If you do go for a crazy bright neon colored eye, you can still use the same lipstick or same lip products and the same blush because you have it in your kit and it works with everything. So the first, I can show you all of them. It's two lip glosses, a lip pencil, and a lipstick. And these are some that I use consistently, all of these, because if you go and buy a lip pencil, don't bother matching it to the lipstick, because if you match it to your own lip shade, you could wear this underneath or with any lipstick you may or may not purchase in the future. So that saves you a whole lot of money, so you don't have to buy, let's say, a pink, a red, a neutral, and a coral or something, in addition to the one that's already matching your lip shade, naturally. So I would suggest going for just one and picking out the one that matches you. And with lipstick, I have one here by Max Factor that's called Plush Blush, which is pretty much my lip color but better. And then we have lip glosses, and I have two here. I have lip products in general. I would suggest, especially if you're in, say, high school or you don't wear a lot of makeup, go for something like this. It's lip gloss that kind of looks like your lips but gives a little shine. Maybe just a clear lip gloss, that would be good too. So if you could only have one lip product, I would suggest a lip gloss.